Alrighty. Get this stream started. Alright, so last night I finished up texturing this. Decided to go with it's kind of like a clean metal for the top part of the cork and the spigot here. Pretty happy with how it turned out. That little smart material I made is working out pretty well. Should be able to get all my assets to look the same or have the same effects anyway. Excuse me, my throat's super dry. So I'm gonna export these textures now. And I have a little setup for cycles. And that also happens to work for Marmoset. It's kind of like the same settings for the most part. Oh man, excuse me. Oh, yeah, change the export path. And then I got all the right there. I have like way too many things put into this setup. I've been having a tough time, not tough time, but I've had to do a lot of trial and error with getting. Excuse me, the settings exactly where I wanted them. All right, pretty good. Don't know if you guys wanna, I can like kind of scroll through the maps here. Roughness. Metallic, normal height, normals, world space, eddy map, curvature, position. That one's so neat looking. I don't know why I always get a kick out of that one. Thickness, even though I didn't use a thickness, but. All right, so let's just save that. And let me go ahead and whoops. Sorry. Software. This. The heck? What's that? There we go. Not even sure what that was. All right, let me close Painter out. Let me I think I can just open the scene back up. Barrel. Gosh, it is so hot here. Oh, maybe I didn't save it. It's weird. I'm usually pretty good about saving. Saving out the files. Oh well. Oh, that's weird. That's the first bake from the other day. Let's just get rid of that. All right. And let's get a different sky in here because I'm not a big fan of this one. Maybe this one. And whoops. I'll just use the bakes from Marmoset for. Oh. Boom. And fusion. A curvature. Beetle map in there. This one, you got it. Metal. Gotta use. Roughness. I believe I have to invert that. Me get a bright sky for now. I think that's it. I'm really not very good at setting up the lighting and stuff in here. It is really fun though. It's probably one of my favorite things, even though I'm terrible at it. I usually just try to do like the, I guess there's like a, ooh. Like a 3-point light setup. Zoom out. See what I'm doing a little better. Like it's way out there. kind of like the Omni ones. That should work, and I'll do one more. This one. Whoa. Yeah, I don't know how, like, there's. I don't know if it's viewport based. Or what? I'm nowhere near that thing. There we go. I'm gonna go with the other Omni. This contact. Make this one like a greenish. And now we'll get a dark background. Maybe this museum? Cathedral? I think this cathedral is the darkest one. If it might be better as a spotlight. I bet this one's better as a spotlight. Wrong way. Maybe I should just put one more, like right over it. Let's see if I can backdrop brightness. Here we go. There we go. All right, that looks pretty fun. I really need to figure out how to do animations. Well, that looks cool. Make this one a little better. Looks pretty sweet. Bog. Whoa. Turn that. Whoa. That's not what I want. Capacity? There we go. Wow. That's powerful. Dispersion, what's that to? Ambient sky? Lights? Oh, that's neat. The lights affect the color of it. Fall off, exponential, inverse square? Linear? Can't tell if that looks cool or not. Just make it like shadow catcher. I guess I should set these to do all this contact refinement stuff. And then main camera. We want to change any of this? Let's see. Vignette. Oh, there it is. Maybe just a little. Sharpen. Sometimes that can be fun. Oh, I don't know if I want any of it, really. Maybe just a touch. Presets. Oh, I wonder what the presets are. Glamour shots, Polaroid. Oh, they're like All right, let's go to settings here. Might as well do a big one if you're gonna render 16x. Whoa, you can really crank up the quality here. Let's do 100, see what that does. Then let's do a capture and open. Oh, here. Nice. That will work. Do one more from like a different angle. Then hop into Blender. My turtle barrel. It does look like a turtle. Nice. All right, I'm going to save that. And why don't we go ahead and open Blender? That's my high poly. That Mac app makes it look so amazing. And over here I have my low poly. All triangulated. Material. New one. Barrel. Go ahead and open up the good old node editor. Control Shift T, that node wrangler. Barrel. I think you just select all of these. Yeah, you just select. There's. Boom. Pretty much just sets it up for you. Uh-oh. What's going on? I don't have a light. Hey, that looks pretty good. I mean, can't really tell what's going on. Good enough. I should try to mimic what I just did in tool bag. I should say I don't really know what I'm doing. I haven't really touched the rendering that. At least not in Blender. Go ahead and just see what I'm at. Yeah, I made this one orange. This one weird light green. This one blue. Pretty strong blue. You know, let me put a little ground plane in here. Darker. I know what happens if I do. Okay, let's make that a little rough because we don't need that to be shiny. Let me, I don't have a camera. I set the camera to view. Yeah. Do a quick little test render there. Should probably make that plane darker, huh? It's kind of distracting. Go, little GPU, go. I have a GTX 1070. It's not very happy. My whole computer is not happy right now. It's pretty hot here and I don't have air conditioning. So I have all my fans running pretty high right now on my computer. So if you can hear background noise, well, that's on top of my regular house fans. That's what it is. Oops. Almost done. Ninety-seven percent, 98, or 97, 98, 9. Got the denoiser running. Seven tiles, eight tiles. Nine. That's looking pretty good. Two more tiles. Nine. Go. Nice. Definitely want to save that. All right. You know what I want to try to do? Make this darker. Make it a little like need to move this light. Doing what? Bring it. This one I want to tone down orange. Thank you. That looks pretty neat, right from this angle. Oh, that's right, I gotta move the damn camera. Here we go, finally. Really gotta crank that one up, huh? All right, one more. Do one more quick render or quick render. Boom. I mean, it is a 4T texture. And this isn't like a true low poly asset, it's like a medium poly. Basically 2500 triangles. I mean, I could definitely optimize it. And I probably will. But then I have to rebake everything. Anyways, this is probably gonna be my last night this week because I am heading out of town for to see some family, so I won't be able to stream the rest of this week. But I do have a couple little videos I'm planning to post while I'm away, one or two, if I can get them edited. I've never really edited any videos yet, pretty much just live stream everything, but I'll try to get some stuff posted next week. But if you're wondering where I am, I'm with my family. But I do have the whole process of this pretty much from start to finish on my YouTube channel. You can drop by there and check it out. Got any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section below. If you like the videos, hit the like button. Lets me know what kind of content people like. And hit the subscribe button, that bell icon. You will get notified every time I make new content or go live. Five more tiles. Man, it is so hot. I can't wait to start using Eevee, man. That's gonna make things go so quick. Three more tiles to denoise. There's probably ways to speed this up, but I haven't figured it out yet. I have done some things to optimize it, but not enough. It would be fun to have one of those NVIDIA Titans. Alright, make sure I save that bad boy. Render 2. I guess I could have just hit the... All right. I'm gonna call it a night, guys. I gotta pack for my trip. So yeah, I won't be here next week, but I might have a video or two to post if I can get them edited. I will do my best. I do have one. It's kind of like a quick walkthrough on how to prepare your model in Blender and export it for baking in Substance Painter or Marmoset Toolbag, either or. Yeah, I'll try to get that edited and posted so you guys have something to check out, and hopefully you'll find it helpful. And again, if you like the video, hit that like button, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon if you want to get notified for future videos. I will see you guys about a week. Good night.